Hello, welcome to Tibet Tutorials from KK Tutorial Center. This session, we are looking at Tibet 2, Part 3, Updating Teaching Standards, Nana Progress, and Booking Lesson Observation. Welcome. Very well. Tibet 2, Part 3. Updating teaching standards, learner progress reports, and lesson observation. So once you log in and click on My Dashboard, you'll be brought to this page showing the three assessment areas, namely, 1, teaching standards, 2, learner progress, 3, lesson attendance. Part A, updating teaching standards. How do you do updates for teaching standards? Step 1, to update teaching standards, click on Update Standard, which is found at the end for the assessment area 1, teaching standards. There is a tab here to be clicked. Update Standard. Click Update Standard. Clicking on Update Standard will bring you to the standards page below. So, standard page will show 5 standards, 5 teaching standards to be updated. And you can see one is professional knowledge and practice, comprehensive learning environment, teacher professional development, teacher contact and professionalism, but especially in professional learning community. And for example, the first one here has a maximum weight of 24, and the status here is indicated yellow. That means it has not been updated. So each standard has targets that needs to be populated with scores called weight. So to update standard 1, at the end here, professional knowledge and practice, there is a new rating. So let's go through populating standard 1, professional knowledge and practice, step 2. On standard 1, click new rating. Click this one, new rating. We want to do the rating for standard 1. Clicking on new rating for standard 1, professional knowledge and practice, will reveal 8 targets as shown below. So this shows that teaching standard 1, professional knowledge and practice, has 8 targets as indicated here. One of them is demonstrate mastery of subject content and use appropriate instructional methods. And the weight is 3, a maximum of 3. And there's a column for maximum weight, abrasive weight, conversion call, Likert scale, and action. And action here is where you will now populate or you will enter the details. So standard target 2 is undertake lesson observation at least once a term. Target 3 is utilizing teaching learning resources effectively. Standard 4. Prepare provisional documents based on the current syllabus or design. Standard number 5, ability to identify learners' ability and learning styles. Standard number 6, ability to identify and nurture learners' talents. Standard number 7, ability to access, retrieve, and integrate ICT in teaching and learning. Ability to carry out, standard 8 is ability to carry out learner assessment, feedback, and reporting on learners' learning, and each of them has to be scored. There is weighting for each one of them, and this is for standard 1. So to begin with, we will populate target 1. At the end here, for target 1, demonstrate mastery of the subject content and use appropriate instructional methods. Click hard weight. On clicking hard weight, this one, you will be brought up a screen for hearting weight. This pop-up screen here, and the target and the target is stated here, and there is enter your weight between 0.1 and 3. I want you to note here that the weight can be 2.1, can be a decimal number between 0.1 and 3, can be a whole number as well. So you need to enter your rating. Then there is a cap category for this target. If there is some challenge, you need to capture here. And cap subcategory will be there. And then we have comment. You need to post your comment here. Right part here indicates verifiable evidence. So we also need to attach evidence. And to do that, we'll go to this section where it says choose file. So we'll click choose file here to choose a file. So I have done populating for my case, where I have indicated here, you need to enter value, you need to click here like that, you need to type comment here, and then click choose file. And mine is as shown below. Step 4, populate a target pop-up screen as shown below and click submit rating. So I have populated here mine to be 2 others. I've chosen others. I've written here good as my comment. And then I will now need to click submit rating for these results to be taken to the system. So after filling the bills and clicking to choose the file, you can now click submit rating to submit your target rating to the system. You will receive the response below after submitting your rating as shown below. So it shows successful. That means your rating values have been submitted to the system. So to proceed to the next target, click OK. It shows that the target one has been populated fully. So clicking OK will now take you to targets page once again. And in the target page, you can see that target number one, demonstrate mastery of the subject content and use appropriate instructional methods. A maximum of 3, populated mine with 2, and the Likert conversion scale has given me 3.3 here. So, step 5. So, repeat the same procedure for each target above, that is target 2, all the way up to target 8. So we will also need to do the same for each of the targets here. Target number 2 here, undertake lesson observation at least once a term, and click heart weight here. So we will do the same procedure to heart weight for target 2, do the same for target 3, target 4, do the same, target 5, do the same, target 6, do the same, target 7, you do the same, target 8, you do the same. Once complete, you will be brought to the following page indicating that standard one has been populated fully. So standard number one has been fully populated, and you can see your values, your header are here, and the conversion is here. That is the system values. So to proceed to the next standard, step 6, click next standard here. Click next standard to proceed to the next standard. This will bring you to the following page, and you will see that you are through with a standard one, professional knowledge and practice, and some facility as indicated as what you have done here. And if you might want to at least change some values for whatever reason, click edit rating to edit. Click edit rating to edit. So you will be brought back to targets page, and you can change the values you may so wish. So by this time, you will be through with standard one, professional knowledge and practice. So once it is complete, it will appear as follows. It means that each of the targets has been populated. So now click on next standard to move to standard number 2, comprehensive learning environment. Standard one has been populated fully 100%. You can see 100% here. The status color changes from yellow to green. So the color green now indicates that the standard is populated fully 100%, as you can see here, and they were out of 24. To proceed to the next standard, that is comprehensive learning and environment, click on new rating that will open the same standard and targets of the same standard. And you can see the targets here. This one has now four targets. Target number one, ability to create child-friendly school, class environment through planned activities to determine or rather to demonstrate respect, equity, inclusion, and moral values. There is another target here, ability to create a stimulating classroom environment, ability to ensure safety of learners, ability to manage learners' conduct and behavior. So there are four targets here to be filled. So you proceed with the same procedure of adding weight. So click to add weight in each of them as you populate. So this will give you the option to add weight. Mine are populated with the three. Indicated my cap as others and all that. Indicated good for comment. And click submit rating. The same procedure. So that means the details should be taken to the system. And on the clicking OK, we'll be brought to the second page here, which shows that the color has changed to green. That is 100% populated. So status color for the standard changes to green to indicate that the standard has been fully populated. So do the same for each of the standards. That is standard number three. Is done the same way. Shown below. Do the same populating standards and submitting, clicking submit rating. So populate the target in the same way. Once true, you'll be brought to the following page. Once you have updated all of them, you'll be brought to this, and you can see that the targets have been populated for each of the standards. And so we need to click next standard like that. We will continue until we exhaust updating standards. When all standards have been populated, the evaluation area 1, teaching standards will be complete and will appear as shown below. The status color changes to green. So when you will have populated all the standards, so everything here is 100% as you can see, and the color will have to indicate to you that it is fully by changing to green. So this color green means all these standards have been populated fully. So to this end, you will be through with updating evaluation area 1, teaching standards. Very well. The next area, assessment area, is updating learner progress records. So we want to see how to update learner progress records. So appraisal area 2 is learner's progress records. Step 1, on learner's progress row, at the end, as you can see here, there are three standards, teaching standards, and the one is has been populated, learner's progress. At the end here, it is update progress. Click update progress. When clicking update progress, learner's progress record will bring you to the following learner's progress records page. So you'll be brought to this page where the category regular learner's progress, we have CBC learner's progress, SLE, that is for special groups like hearing impaired, HI here, visual impaired, as you can see there, the list is long, and the others. So you will choose your category, but by default, you will be brought to regular learner's progress. And here, you can see that there has been given an option, set subject target. So now click set subject target to be able to set a subject target. On clicking set subject target, the following learner's progress record screen will pop up. This is the screen for setting the subject target. And you can see indicated here, learner's progress record. There is a class or form where you choose your class, and then there's subject. And default here, they have put a greater because it's alphabetical. You will choose your subject here. And then there is a target mean score. You need to enter your target mean score for the class. And then once you'll be through, you will click save target. So step two, populate each section as shown below. Have done population for my case. You can see here I have chosen from two subject mathematics. Target mean score 6.5. Now click save record to save your details. I will need to click save record to save your details. This will bring the following pop-up screen showing that progress record update is successful. So once you have clicked save record, you will get this pop-up screen saying successful. You will have saved your record is saved successfully. So to proceed, you click OK. On click OK, you will be brought to the following page showing that the record has been captured. And you can see the record here has been captured. That is mathematics form 1. Previous mean not indicated, but target that I had at 7.5 is here indicated. Current term mean has not been posted. Then there is remove and update. We shall see what happens next to that. So step 3. Repeat the same procedure for each of your classes and subjects. Once through, you will be brought to the following page. So if you repeat all of them, you will have, for example, here I have indicated my subjects, four classes, form 1, form 2, form 3, form 4, negated the target mean and all that, and there is an option for remove and also update. So the function of remove here, you may want to remove one of these entries, so click remove. And to update, you will click update. So that's all about capturing learners' progress records. Next session is viewing lesson attendance. So another assessment area is lesson attendance. So it is very important to note here that as a teacher, you can only view records of your lesson attendance. And we have to note that the person in charge of lesson attendance is the Deputy Head of Institution. So it will be the Head of Institution to post your lesson attendance, which is actually recorded daily, and then to be captured for you. Okay, so you can only view as a teacher. Section D, booking lesson observations. One of the things for debate is a lesson observation. You must be observed as you do the teaching at least once. So step one, click on self appraisal, which is this one, and then you'll get two options, self-assessment and lesson observation. So this will collapse and repeat options, self-assessment and lesson observation. Now click on lesson observation. Click on lesson observation. This will bring you to the following web page. And it indicates my lesson observation, and somewhere here you can see request observation. So step two, click request observation. So you must, as a teacher, must request to be observed. So you click request observation. On clicking request for observation, the following request for observation screen pops up. This screen will pop up. This one is called request for lesson observation screen. So you will need to enter your message and say something. You need to type here, and then once through, you will click send request. So how do you do that? Step three, populate the screen as shown below and click send request. So I have, you need to type your message. For example, here, my guests have indicated, hi, I would like to request to be observed on my lesson on Tuesday, the 8th of December 2020, from 4 West class at 2 to 2:40 p.m. Kind regards. So after entering here, click send request. So I click here. This will bring you to the following pop-up screen showing request has been captured successfully. So that marks the end for debate 2, part 3 tutorial. So debate 2, part 4 tutorial will cover DOI portal, and it will be coming soon. Thank you for watching.